6 years ago, we decided to take a 180-degree turn from the life we were living and do something unique and different. There are many reasons people look at building alternatively. For us, we wanted to reduce the amount of formaldehyde our family was being exposed to with modern laminated wood products used in new home construction. We're also looking for a way to be more grounded and more connected to nature, and well, also just to be different. We set our goal to build with straw bale, not knowing much about it, but hearing that it was all the rave. We found it to be the poster child darling of the alternative construction, the technique everyone knew about and was most widely accepted in North American alternative construction. What we didn't bank on is a change of farming practices over the last decade. You see, mixed farming and family farms have been replaced by agribusiness. The family farm used to be small and labor was bountiful, but today's farms have grown on average tenfold in size with the same amount of physical labor to run them. What this means is that straw that used to be used for square bales is now either chopped and spread finely over the field, or if it is used for cattle bedding, it is now rolled in round bales weighing in excess of 1,000 pounds. For an alternative building enthusiast, this meant 2 years of trying to source a supplier of square bales. We finally started construction on our first building with great expectations of slapping it together in a weekend. This was our limited understanding of how quick it was to build with straw bale. Get a few of your friends together and presto, your weekend project is done, unlike traditional construction. The wake-up call came when we realized that the foundation and structural work is no different than wood frame construction, and also that 30-pound bales become extremely heavy when you start lifting them over your head. We also found that anyone can slap bales into a wall. Just like wood construction, not everyone can do it well. Good construction technique goes a long way, and understanding stuffing, fitting, cutting, and retying bales meant the difference between a beautifully constructed, well-insulated home and a building that was extremely difficult to finish well. So fast forward a few years, and we were set to begin construction on our large studio space. Our bales were now deteriorated after 3 years of sitting outside unprotected, and frankly, we weren't interested in trying to source yet more square bales after the ordeal we had the first time around. When we looked at alternative ways of constructing based on materials we had available, 1. Misformed wet old bales, and 2. Lots of clay from a recently dug natural pond. We looked at adobe brick and cob and were disappointed with both the labor and the insulating R values of both methods. Although these construction techniques have a place in the world, that place is definitely not the northern climates of Saskatchewan prairies. Driving rain, freezing snow, temperatures in excess of 40 degrees Celsius during the summer heat and minus 30 degrees Celsius in the winter pushed the extremes of this type of construction. The insulating value simply wasn't there without artificial means as a break between inner and outer walls. Almost by accident, we did stumble across another type of construction used in Germany almost 1,000 years ago, called straw-like clay. With Germany having a similar climate as Western Canada, this method really caught our attention. It was similar to straw bale, but formed similar to cob. With cob, a large amount of clay is hand-mixed with manure, straw and water into a manageable sized ball that can be used to form the walls while wet. Adobe is very similar, except the balls are formed into bricks which are then allowed to sun dry before being used to form the walls. Because of the density of cob and adobe brick, construction is laborious, heavy, and extremely slow. Alternatively, straw-like clay reverses those ratios of cob and simplifies the raw ingredients. A large portion of straw is mixed with clay water slip. This forms a light, easy to handle mixture that can be placed by hand, by pitchfork, or by machine. This mixture has a high insulating value of R of 1.6 per inch of wall depth. Because of the lightness of the material, it makes an ideal fill, but requires additional support framing for structural load. This typically isn't a concern for people who are interested in straw bale construction, as post and beam is typically the most popular way to build anyways. Once a frame of the building is erected, forming boards are then screwed to both sides of the structure. The straw-like clay, or SLC, is mixed and dumped into the wall voids. A light tamping ensures all gaps are filled, and also folds the fibers of the straw, essentially helping tie the knots and weave, creating an incredibly strong wall capable of tremendous lateral force. Once the cavity is filled, the form is removed and the wall is left to cure for a few weeks before finishing plaster or stucco is applied. Because forming boards are used, the finished walls are absolutely perfect, straight, and smooth. There is no sewing, no tying, no stuffing involved like with straw bale. And because you're working with a mixture that gets poured into place, there's huge freedom to choose the depth of the wall. This method can be used to form walls anywhere from 3.5 inches thick right up to 2 feet thick. There is no concern of cracking due to drying times like with cob. And best of all, any type of fiber can be used from straw to leaves or even wood chips. This means that affordable, readily available, modern 1,000-pound bales can be used instead of hard-to-source square bales. This also means people who may not want or cannot lift square bales can still construct their own bale building. And because of the lightness of the material, it can be used by forming by hand, but also lends itself well to modern mechanized equipment. The diversity of this material is simply incredible and helps simplify the finishing techniques so critical to good bale construction. Simply put, SLC combines the very best of several alternative building techniques while allowing a lot of grace and a lot of versatility of both depth of wall and fill materials used.